One Piece Books presents The Rising of the Shield Hero, Volume 2, by Aneko Yusagi. Performed by Kurt Kanazawa. Prologue. Shared Pain. I woke up in the castle storeroom. It was musty. I really hated it in there, but I felt pretty well rested. Snoring. I could hear rhythmic snoring coming from the pile of straw next to me. A young girl named Raftalia was sleeping there. Let's take a minute to review what's happened. My name is Naofumi Iwatani. I'm a sophomore in college. I was born in Japan, just like everyone else. To be honest, I was always a bit of an otaku. I was at the library flipping through a book called The Records of the Four Holy Weapons when, for whatever reason, I found myself transported to the fantasy world it spoke of. I had been summoned to serve the role of the shield hero. The world was suffering under waves of destruction, in which hordes of monsters and horrible disasters spilled over from other dimensions through rifts in space. Four heroes were summoned to protect the world from harm. I had a shield on my arm that I couldn't remove. Maybe it was under some sort of curse? I found myself unable to go on the offense at all. All I could do was defend. But I had some experience with online MMORPGs, so I focused on defending myself and recruited someone else to attack for me. We set out on our adventure, and I was very excited. But I fell into a wicked trap. Someone framed me for a crime I didn't commit, and I found myself convicted. So nobody trusted me from that point on. I couldn't make any friends or get anyone to help me, and they ran me out of the castle without a word. I was in a really tough spot. I figured I would just not do anything. I thought I didn't have to fight against the waves of destruction. I was wrong. The waves of destruction arrived around once every month, and we heroes were instantly transported to the site of destruction. I was forced to protect a bunch of people that I didn't care a lick for. It wasn't fair at all. I did all I could to raise money to survive, and all the while people jeered at me. They threw rocks at me. So that girl that was sleeping next to me, Raftalia, she's a demi-human slave. I bought her. Slavery still exists in this world, and in this particular country, Melromark, there were people with animal attributes called demi-humans. They were sold into slavery all the time. When I bought her, she was just a little girl, but as we leveled up, she grew very quickly until she appeared only slightly younger than me. Apparently, demi-humans grew differently than the rest of us. They developed based on their level, not their age. In the beginning, I thought I'd work her hard, considering she was a slave and all. But soon enough, this pompous jerk named Motoyasu forced me to battle. During the fight, Raftalia believed in me and attempted to sacrifice her own freedom to protect me. Well, there were other things too, but in the end, we became close friends, and we trust each other deeply. Honestly, for the longest time, I couldn't have cared less if everyone in the world just dropped dead. But now, I sort of feel like I want to help out. Raftalia woke up and rubbed her eyes.
Good morning, Mr. Naofumi.
Morning.
Looking at her again, I thought she really was quite beautiful. Her face was like a work of art. I could use words besides beautiful, but I'll hold off for now. Her hair was brown and hung in loose curls down her back. Her eyes were big and bright. They were the color of a deep red tea. They were the most beautiful eyes I'd ever seen. With all that she had been through, I don't know how her eyes were still so pure and kind. They were too pure to belong in a body of her age. They really were the most charming thing about her.
I leveled up and earned money with Raftalia until the first wave of destruction came. It was the first wave I'd seen, but it was the second wave that had visited the world. It was a hard fight, but I'll tell you all about that later on. The really tough stuff happened afterward. Should we go get some breakfast?
Yeah. Think we can get some in the castle dining hall?
Perhaps. Let's go see. So we made for the dining hall, and I kept running over all we'd been through. By the way, my bad name had yet to be cleared. The castle officials treated me coldly. Anytime I tried to go to the cafeteria, the guards would turn me away. The knights and other heroes are still eating, they'd say. Come back when everyone else is done. If I hadn't been forced to be the shield hero, if only I could have attacked, I'd have taken care of that whole crowd a long time ago. And I wouldn't have let being a hero stop me. We finished eating and were led into the audience chambers. The occasion was to be one of celebration. We were all about to be compensated for our efforts during the wave of destruction. Give me a break. If they were going to make us wait a day before they paid us, they should have said so in the first place. I swear, trash was just trying to piss me off. The thought of spending another second with this group of jerks was unbearable. What if I got an ulcer? The person I called Trash was, in fact, the king of this land, Ultcray Melromark. The second, the third? I can't remember. Anyway, apparently he was the one who summoned me here. When I'd been framed and accused and convicted, he never even tried to find out the truth. He just let it all go and let me take the fall. Some king, right? And then, just last night, he used his authority to throw a fit and cause a big disturbance.
Now then, we will distribute the reward funds for your performance in the last battle and also your preparatory funds for the next wave.
That's what I really needed, money for preparations. Trash had promised to give the money to all of us heroes. An attendant entered the room. He held a bag of money stiffly in his fist.
Now then, to each of the heroes.
I turned to look at the bags of money. At the very least, they were sure to provide us with 500 pieces of silver for each month. What would I buy with it? It would probably be wise to start with a new weapon for Raftalia. Or maybe it was time to invest in some better armor. Come to think of it, I also wanted some new materials to use for making medicine. I could let my shield absorb them too. I could see what kind of abilities they got me. I listened to all the coins sliding around inside the bag and fantasized about what I would buy. The attendant held the bag open so that I could see the contents. I quickly counted the coins inside. Yes, there seemed to be 500 pieces in there.
To Mr. Motoyasu, both in recognition of his performance and to express our future expectations for him, we present 4,000 silver.
Hey now. I was taken aback. I staggered and quickly looked over at the very heavy bag that Motoyasu was now holding. If I were to say something, it certainly wouldn't get me anything but contempt though, so I just bit my tongue. I felt my fingers curling involuntarily into a fist. They called this guy Mr. Motoyasu, but his real name was Motoyasu Kitamura. Like myself, he had been summoned from an alternate Japan, and he was one of the four heroes, the spear hero. He was 21 years old. The other heroes apparently had experience in and knew all about this world. They knew it from some game they had played back in their own worlds. But they didn't share any of that knowledge with me. They framed me and kicked me when I was down. So this Motoyasu guy apparently ended up getting stabbed because of his womanizing and then woke up here. That's just what he says, though, so who knows if it is true or not. He only allowed women into his party. It was like he was setting up some kind of harem or something. Last night, thinking that I was abusing Raftalia as a slave and to satisfy some kind of messiah complex, he decided to try and save her from me and challenged me to a duel. Normally, a duel would have to be agreed on by both parties.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.